I think we have shook hands several times with him, but believe me, it is important again that I receive him on your behalf and shake him with the servant of Jesus, who is finally that we have our peace. Thank you very much. Hands of criminals, kidnappers, is a result of his or her own effort. If there is any, I will not believe. It is as a result of the divine intervention of God. And because of that, I felt that as a young ministry, being given this trial at a takeoff. Because the question I kept asking when this happened is that, God, why our ministry? And of all about 19 ministries we have in Niger State, ours is the youngest. Why should it be us? And believe you me, the encouragement I receive under God's inspiration is that God says, those he loves, he chastises. And this trial stands a solid foundation for victory of this ministry. To take Niger State to greater height under the very, very lovely administration of this chief servant. And I know that because we have a vision, because we are definite in our direction, obviously the devil will not be happy. And that was why the devil used all its cronies and agents. Because you are trying to try God and you cannot try God. Be with me. That for the past 10 or 11 days, because that was on Saturday, remember? I'm sorry, Sunday, for the past 9 days, so to say, for those 7 or so days, there was no life in this ministry, except for enemies behind the mask. That we do not know, but God knows them. But for any right-thinking person, and for somebody who knows that life belongs to God, and that we are supposed to be one another's keeper, that's why God created us many to live under the earth. I saw that there was no life in this ministry for the whole week. Up and down with the security operatives, but I saw that in the faces of many staff, everybody was demoralized, everybody was weak. But believe you me, your attitude encouraged me. I noticed that each one of you, call it whatever they call it, is it senior, is it junior, as far as I know, you're a staff, and every staff that knows his or her sword is valuable. If you are not sweeping, if you don't sweep, it won't work. I mean, consulting with malams, consulting with men and people of God to pray. And I felt that, look, we should not just receive this lovely friend, colleague, father, uncle, brother, in just a quiet and one-to-one manner alone. We should together receive him, because this ministry is a family. When I came, you remember I told you that I want us to operate like a family. And so if something came to take away a member of your family, and not just an ordinary member, but a key leader of the family, you know that there is no way that family can be stable. Thanks, example. That was what I meant for us. But we thank God that God stood by all of us and God intervened. again and you are back to us. Believe me, we are very happy. We join your family. We join your
kids and kins to say that he has shown to us. I know
if we give you time to tell us the ordeal, believe you me, it is not palatable. Even if we didn't see it, you can just imagine. You are traveling, somebody crossed you on the way, and under arms picked you up, and that was all. Seized your freedom, and that was all. Help me, God. So let me please request all of us that, one, we should not live our lives carelessly. Two, no matter how careful you are in living your life, remember that it is only God that can protect us. And because our means of communication with God is prayers, please let us pray constantly. Pray without ceasing. And don't be too selfish in your prayers. Pray for everybody. Are you getting it? Because it can happen to just anybody. Pray for everybody, no matter your faith. Pray for members, when you are praying, remember members of the family of the Minister of Youth Affairs and Strategy. Remember the Chief Servant, the Governor of Niger State. Remember all those who are working with him. Remember our emirs. Remember everybody. Pray for children. Pray for whoever. Pray for God intervention. Pray for God supreme protection. After all, it was a challenge given to Niger State. The most peaceful state, isn't it? So the devil came and said, you have been priding yourself that you are the most peaceful. I will show you. But we thank God that God intervened. I remember when the whole tension was on, off and tense. Assuming you don't have your PAMSEC pack life, I said that is not my assumption. That's what I told you. I said, sorry, it's not my assumption. Oh, are you trying to join kidnappers? He said, no. You were just trying to, you know, somehow, you know, people want to prepare your mind. I said, sorry, but that is not my assumption. My assumption is that my pamphlet will come back alive. It's as if I'm even sitting down with him already. Then he said, you are strong, bro. I said, no, God is strong. I knew it was a test. It was a test to many of us. It was a test to him, test to his family, test to us in the ministry, test to us in the executive council, test to the governor, test to all of us, to humanity. And we thank God that God has proved to all of us that he is our God. Please, I'm begging you, everybody, women and men, young and old, don't pick anybody in your mind as enemy. It's not necessary, it's not worth it. If you have any misgivings and conflict with anybody, believe me, walk to that person and share it. Are you getting it? Walk to the person and share it. So that life will just go on. We thank you very much for all your prayers, for all your support, for all your encouragement. Once again, PAMSEC, you are welcome. Now our ministry is complete. Now we can walk. Now we can smile. I was waiting to see the game. And I said, these kidnappers, they don't fear, sir. They kidnap somebody with game. If you see somebody with game, you don't say this one, that will you say that. So leave them alone. We thank God. You are most welcome, sir. I'm sure you have a word for all of us.
Amen.
the Directors General, Youth and NGO, other directors here present, all members of staff of the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Strategy. Let me say that I have heard what the Special Advisor has dispatched to our Honorable Commissioner. And the whispering is not out of place. Let me just say briefly that, Honorable Commissioner, I appreciate you. Honorable Commissioner, I appreciate everybody in this ministry. Honorable Commissioner, let me say through you, I thank the Chief Servant exceedingly for his kind intervention, personally and on official level. Part of it was that on Sunday, 8th November 2009, I was kidnapped. And by the 13th of the same month, your prayers, your concern, your cares, God saw you and saw your prayers and accepted them. I was rescued. Let me say that nobody should think this thing is a prearranged type of kidnap. No way. Let me say that the kidnappers told me I was never a target of this kidnap, but I was a victim of circumstances. So, as a victim of circumstances, it means that anybody could have been picked. Anybody at all. So for us, like the Honourable Commissioner said, let us pray and pray for ourselves and for everybody. That is the weapon. There wasn't much I could do as a captive, somebody who had been captured, somebody who had been restrained from his freedom. But it was you who worked round the clock to ensure that, yes, God intervenes. And he did intervene. And his intervention is why we are here this morning to smile with you and to warmly welcome me back to the family, back to the fold of friends and well wishes. Honorable Commissioner, something to pin, you cry. When you are overjoyed, you also cry. If you see tears coming out from my eyes, it is the tears of joy and not the tears of pain. We are concerned with the people out there. Exactly what's happening to us. So, the mental torture, you suffer. If you don't want me to shed tears, let me just say I appreciate you and thank you very much.